circular motion video lesson number 2. The objective for subtopic 6.1 uniform circular motion describe uniform circular motion converts unit between degrees, radian and revolution or rotation. In this video, you will learn about kinematics of uniform circular motion. We have a physical quantity that describes kinematics of the motion, such as distance versus displacement, velocity versus speed, and acceleration. Consider an object which moves in uniform circular motion as in this figure from point 1 to point 2. From point 1 to point 2, it goes through part of the circle S. So how to calculate the distance? The distance S. So, S equal to R theta. R is the radius of the circle and theta is the displacement, the angle in radian, angular displacement in radian. Conversion between degree and radian. When an object makes through a complete circle of one revolution, the angular displacement theta in the entire circle is 360 degree. So, for using equation just now, S equal to R theta, the angular displacement theta should be in radian. Therefore, you should know how to convert from degree to radian or from radian to degree. Based on this figure, object start at 0 degree when it's come and complete one circle, it is equal 360 degree or 2 pi in radian. 90 degree angle is only pi over 2 radian. 180 degree is pi radian. So, conversion factor for a complete circle 360 degree equal to 2 pi radian. Then when you come to conversion from degree to radian, 1 degree is equal to 2 pi over 360 radian. And from radian to degree, 1 radian equal to 360 over 2 pi degree. Physical quantity that relates to time in circular motion. We have two physical quantities here, period and the frequency. The meaning of period is the time the object takes to travel one complete cycle or revolution, or is equal to the amount of time it takes for an object to return to the same position. The symbol used for period is T and the unit is second, because the unit of time. Frequency. Frequency, the symbol used is F. It is defined as the number of revolution or cycle or rotation completed in 1 second. The unit of the frequency is hertz, symbol Hz or per second. Relationship between period and frequency. The equation is F equal to 1 over T or 1 over the period. For example, if an object takes 2 seconds to complete 10 revolutions, what is the period and what is the frequency? Calculation of the period. Okay, period means that the time taken for the object to complete just one revolution. That's why you have the time taken of 2 seconds divided by 10 revolutions. You get 0.2 seconds. The period is 0.2 seconds. But for the frequency, the meaning of the frequency is how many complete revolution it takes in 1 second. Since the object takes 2 seconds to complete 10 revolutions, meaning that in 1 second it can complete 5 revolution. So the frequency is 5 hertz or 5 revolution in 1 second. Speed versus velocity in uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion can be described as the motion of an object at constant speed. As it moves in a circle, it is constantly changing its direction. But the magnitude of the velocity is constant. Speed is a scalar quantity. So its magnitude is constant value. But for velocity, velocity is a vector quantity. It is not constant because of the direction keep changing. The direction of the velocity is tangent to the path at any instant. So the change in velocity vector is due to the change in the direction. How to determine the speed? Speed is equal to distance over time. We can use this equation because the speed for uniform circular motion is constant. If the distance is given in terms of the number of revolution per minute, how to determine the speed in unit SI unit, which is meter per second? So conversion of the speed when you have number of revolution is number of revolution time 2 pi r, the distance taken to complete 1 revolution per 60 second, which is 1 minute. Then you get the SI unit for speed, meter per second. Acceleration. Does the object move in uniform circular motion has an acceleration? You know acceleration is the rate of change of the velocity. Object moving in a circle is accelerating, even though an object undergoing uniform circular motion and is moving with constant speed, it is accelerating due to its change in direction. And the direction of the acceleration is inward or toward the center of the circle. There is a change in velocity due to the change in direction. Delta V is equal to V2 minus V1. The direction of the instantaneous at any instant of the acceleration is always along a radius of the circle toward its center, which is toward the inside of the circle, and it is perpendicular to the instantaneous velocity. The action is directed to the center of the circle. That's why it is called as centripetal acceleration, meaning that center pointing. Equation of centripetal acceleration. So the centripetal acceleration depends on speed of the object, radius of the circle. Equation A centripetal A subscript C refer to centripetal acceleration equal to V square over R, where V is the speed of the object, R is the radius of the circle, AC is the centripetal acceleration.